Okay, I got to clamp back down in approximate rotation. I'm using a wiggler here, and I'll, you see how it's intruded up the wiggler. Pretty much right on the money. We're going to put the boring head back in and see how that aligns. See if we have to adjust that any. Back on zero. We had it, so let's see. I think we're right on the money. We'll just go back in there nice and slow and just checking my clamps. Getting pretty close to going through there, I think. Go a little bit more. Thank you. didn't work again, but not sure why there. Okay, have the wiggler back in, and we're just gonna roughly line it up with the mark, little center punch mark I have in the middle. Put a couple clamps on light, and fire's still going today. We can hear the bombers. Helicopter flew over a little bit ago, carrying a 300-gallon bucket, 250-gallon bucket, something like that. Okay, line up the cutter, I'll show you what happened. What happened was I didn't have enough depth on that outside. And so it hit on that outside of the groove it's cutting, and caught and twisted it. So that's what happened. So I ground a bit of it off. See how it looks. Looks really good. I have my VFD set up so I can do a jog, which is pretty nice. Forward or reverse. And it's set so it just does a few RPM. And just to check, be able to check stuff. Double check my clamps. Okay. See if we can do this now. We ended up with a couple little dings on the outside, but this is actually a little bigger than I want it, so I'm gonna figure out a way to clean that up on the outside. Might even just throw it in the lathe. We'll see about that. Okay, we got it out of there. Let's figure something out. Okay, well, I got it set up in the lathe. I'm going to turn this down to 100, I wanted 1.5 inches, I should say. So, I'm right there at 122. So, or I should say 1522. So, another 22 thousandths off of there will be really nice. I just got to cut it easy, and this is not that super precise, but I went pretty close to 1.5 inches. Or 12. Well, to the calipers, it's 1.5 inches. I'm going to turn it over and we'll do the other half. Using a little parallel with a bunch of shims there, and we'll get it pretty doggone flat that way. Pretty good. Actually, I'm probably going to be against that shoulder. Not quite flat. End up with a little ridge in the middle of it. We'll get rid of it. Or 14. It's awful good. We got a little ridge in the middle, but we'll have to think of something on that now. All I know is it fits perfect. I tested it out on the indicator. Okay, maybe I'll just sand that off. Okay, so what I did is I just kind of buffed that ridge a little bit on the Scotch-Brite wheel. Just a little lap sand on the bench on the sides. And we'll just test fit it on the back of this nice little indicator. Perfect fit, I would say. Now we can do something useful with this to mount it and use it for something. I'm not sure yet what, but it's a little more usable right now. And it's a nice, really old indicator. I don't know how much this thing weighs, but it feels like it's full of lead almost. It's very heavy. But now we got a nice little back we can work with. There's a little drawing I had sketched up real quick. All right, well, thanks for watching the project.